Hello everyone. In this video, I'll be talking about architecture of embedded system software approach. The previous video is discussed about the architecture of embedded system hardware approach, but in this video, we'll talk about the software approach. Learning outcomes. At the end of this video, you will be able to draw the software architecture of an embedded system. You'll be able to describe the importance of the elements in the software architecture of an embedded system. This is the architecture of an embedded system. Here you can see there is a hardware. For using this hardware, we need some software, and that software, for that software, we need the operating system and application software. So this is the part of the software architecture. So hardware architecture, as I said, already been discussed. We'll look at the software architecture. Let us look first at the operating system. What is an operating system? Operating system is the piece of software with which user interacts with hardware. When the system is switched on, first OS is loaded into the main memory, that is RAM. The managing the multiple tasks is done by OS. OS is doing the scheduling. We'll look at the details of this OS further. Before going further to the details of the operating system, at this point, can you write the answer to the question, list the different operating systems used in mobile phones? As mobile phone is one of the embedded system, so you know what are the different operating systems that are used in mobile phones. You can pause the video for some time and can write the answer to this question. Thank you. I hope you have written the answer. So the different operating systems used in mobile phones are, I'm sure that you have written the answers like Android OS, Web OS, Windows OS, Symbian OS, Palm OS, iPhone OS and BlackBerry OS. So we know all the names, these names like Android, Windows, iPhone and all. But we do not know that these are the operating systems and what exactly an operating system is. So let us look at that part of what is an operating system. Before going to the operating system, I just want to tell you there are the categories of the operating systems. What are the categories? Single tasking OS versus multitasking OS. OS is the operating system. Single user OS versus multi-user OS. Command driven OS versus GUI based OS. What is single tasking OS? Single tasking OS is the operating system which allows you to perform a single task at a time. For example, if I'm using the DOS operating system, I'm able to perform a single task at a time. I cannot perform a multiple task at a time. I need to exit from one task, then only I can do the next task. That is what is the single tasking OS. Multitasking OS. For this, the best example can be the Windows. When I'm using the Windows operating system, I'm performing the multiple tasks. Like I have connected to internet, I'm using the file sharing, maybe I'm working on Excel. So I'm doing multiple tasks on that OS. So that is the multitasking OS. The example is Windows. Second type category is single user OS. Single user OS, in this, the single user is using the operating system. As I said right now, that Windows operating system is a single user operating system. In multi-user operating system, the multiple users are sharing the operating systems in time sharing, time division multiplexing. So that is a multi-user OS. The example of this multi-user is Unix. Multi-user OS is Unix, where every user feels as if he alone is using that operating system. Next operating system is the command-driven operating system versus GUI-based operating system. Command-driven operating system, again the best example is the DOS operating system, which is a command-driven operating system. I need to write the command to execute a particular task. Whereas GUI is the graphical user interface based operating system, is nothing but the Windows operating system, where I can perform the different tasks at the mouse clicks. There is a GUI which is available. I need to click that and then I have to perform the task. That is GUI based operating system. This is the software architecture of an embedded operating system. In this you can see there is operating system, there is the application programming interface and application software. The operating system consists of different parts such as kernel, communication software, libraries, device manager and file system. We'll look at first the parts of this operating system or elements of this operating system one by one. So these are the elements of operating system: kernel, device manager, that is communication software is networking protocol software, libraries, file system. File system is optional. Why it is optional, that I'll talk about. Next comes to kernel. The element of an operating system is a kernel. This is the operating system part, which is kernel. It is heart of the operating system. Why it is called as the heart of the operating system? This is because it manages the tasks by scheduling the tasks and by providing inter-task communication. It also provides memory management services, time management services, interrupt handling services and device management services. So it is doing very crucial tasks. So the name may be for that, it's a kernel, and so it's called as a heart of the operating system. Next comes is a device manager. Here is a device manager. So this device manager, as the name is there, it is managing the device. Which devices? So it is managing the IO devices. For what? It manages the IO devices to send and receive the data from the embedded system. IO devices are managed by operating system through interrupts and device drivers. What are the device drivers? Device drivers are nothing but this is an interface. It is providing an interface between application and hardware. Next, it comes a file system. Here is a file system. So embedded system has constraints of the size as well as it need to be real time, so that there is a constraint and for the memory to be used. So generally the most of the embedded systems do not have a secondary storage. So when I said file system, that file system is optional. If at all it is needed, then only it is used. So most of the embedded systems do not have a secondary storage. If the file system at all required, a small system can be developed on a flash memory. And some embedded systems use secondary storage just for the booting purposes. Otherwise, embedded systems do not allow to use the secondary storage. Next comes the communication software. This is the communication software. What does it mean? If I need that my embedded system to be network enabled, then in that case, the protocol, TCP/IP protocol, for example, a TCP/IP protocol need to be integrated with that OS. So then only my embedded system will be network enabled. So for that, the communication software is doing the job. Embedded system has a communication interfaces such as Ethernet and USB. Next is the element is the libraries. This is the part as a libraries. OS may have the libraries such as C, C++ library files in the object code. These files are available in object code and these can be used through API calls. What is API? What are API calls? That we'll see further. This is the application software. So application software is this part. This is the application software part. So when I'm using my mobile phone, if I'm using PhonePe, then I'm using an application. If I'm using any other app, Swachh Bharat app, it's nothing app when I'm saying it's an application. It's an application software I'm using. And it to be developed by the over the operating system. For example, if I have Android phone, for that the app developed is different. For Windows phone, the application developed is different. So the application software need to be developed above the operating system, which operating system that we are using in, and obtain the development tools for that operating system, and that is the job done by the application software. So this is the operating system. For that, on that we are developing a application software, right? But what is there in between? Let us look at that. So in between these two, between the OS and the application software, there is an application programming interface, which is called API, Application Programming Interface. API is used by developers to write the application software. The application software needs to be written, and that will be written by the developers, and API will be used for developing this application software by the developers. And it provides the functional calls. API provides the functional calls to access operating system services. That is nothing but the application programming interface. These are the references used for preparing this video. Thank you.